हेलो स्टूडेंट, वेलकम टू AI SSMS इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ इंफॉर्मेशन टेक्नोलॉजी। माई सेल्फ डॉक्टर AR देशमुख फ्रॉम इंजीनियरिंग साइंस डिपार्टमेंट। इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट डिफ्रैक्शन ऑफ लाइट। नाउ इन द 17th सेंचुरी सर इसाक न्यूटन रोट इन हिज थ्योरी ऑफ ऑप्टिकल फिनोमिना which is called as optics, that light is never known to follow the crooked passages nor to bend into the shadow. In his theory, he explained the particles of light always travel in straight line and how object position within the path of light particles would cast a shadow because the particles could not spread out behind the object. This theory is also called as corpuscular theory of light, which is considered to be the light is made up of particles. However, this theory is not able to explain the phenomena such as interference, diffraction and polarizations. So later on, Huygens proposed a wave theory or light wave theory, in which he explained on a much smaller scale, when light waves pass near the barrier or the obstacle, they tend to bend around the corners and spread at oblique angles, and this bending of light at the obstacle or at the corner and spread at oblique angles, this phenomena is called as a diffraction of light. And this can occurs when a light wave passes very close to the edge of an object or through a tiny opening such as slit or the aperture. Now, diffraction is often explained in terms of Huygens principle, which states that each point on the wavefront, as we can see here, these are the wavefronts after starting from the source, this wavefront can be considered as a source of the new wave. All point on the wavefront serve as point sources of a spherical secondary wavelet. After time t, the new position of the wavefront will be that of the surface tangent to the secondary wavefronts. Now, as we can see in the figure on the left top, when the light passes through this blade, then light seems to be bending at the corners and spreading at a certain angle and giving us the bright and the dark fringes. Now, where are the diffraction maxima and minima? After the central maximum, the next maximum occurs about halfway between the first and the second minimum. So as we can see here, at the center, the central maximum is there, and by these conditions we get the next maxima and the minima. So for the minima condition, we have a sine theta equal to n lambda, where n equal to 1, 2, 3. And for the maxima, we have a sine theta equal to n plus 1 by 2 lambda, where n equal to 1, 2, 3, dot, dot, dot. In this way, we'll get the minima and the maxima for the diffraction pattern. Now let us understand the diffraction by circular aperture or the lens. When the light passes from the point source, a small circular aperture, it does not produce a bright dot as an angle, but rather it diffuses to the circular disc known as array disc. And this disc is surrounded by much fainter concentric circular rings. Now this example of diffraction is of great importance because the eye and many optical instruments have the circular apertures. Now a complex analysis leads to for this particular circular aperture sin theta equal to 1.22 lambda by d here, which we can get the first minima. And if you compare this, we will have compare this with the single slit a diffraction pattern, we can get the first minima at the point sin theta equal to lambda by d. Thank you.